What I'm going to show you next is how you can resize your image. So this is a little composite that we made with a few images. We added some text and we were just pretty much going through the basics of Photoshop. You can review the previous two videos that I made in this series if you want more information. Since we are specifically talking about creating images for web use, the physical size as well as the file size are considerations that we definitely need to think about when we're creating imagery for the web. So the first thing that I want to do is check the actual physical size of my image. The easiest way to do that is to go to the image pull-down menu and to go to image size. And when you do this, it'll open up your image size dialog box. So this is going to give you the dimensions of your image. I am currently viewing my image in pixels, and that's because my ruler is set to pixels. So let me just back up really quickly and show you how you can alter that. My ruler is on. You can view the ruler by going to view and making sure rulers is checked. I believe by default it's not on, so you may need to turn that on. And if you want to alter the units of measurement inside the ruler, the easiest way to do this is to right click, and then you can choose pixels if you're working for the web, or some other units of measurement if you're doing something for print or whatnot, but I'll leave mine in pixels. Now that my ruler is set to pixels, when I do something like open my image size dialog box, it will also default to displaying in pixels. You can change the units here as well, but since I primarily do web work, I prefer just to go ahead and always work with pixels. It is worth mentioning that for web-based use, 72 resolution is absolutely fine. So again, if you are used to working with print-based documents, you're probably used to working with 300 or possibly even 600, but for the web, 72 is fine. So the physical size of my image needs to be reduced. This is really large, especially for web use. So what I need to do is I need to consider, where is this going to be used on my website? What is the largest size that I may want to use this image on my website? And you'll need to think about your target audience and what you're building and where this is going to reside before you make that sort of decision. What I will do is I'm going to reduce this down to about 1200 pixels. So I'm going to go ahead and type in 1200 for the width. When I do that, my height is automatically going to update, and that's because these are currently linked. That's all I need to do. I'm going to click OK, and you can see that my image was 34, almost 35 megabytes. It's going down to 3, so this is much better. This is the raw footage size, so don't worry that this is not what we would ultimately be publishing to the web. It more than likely is going to zoom out or shrink your image down in Photoshop. So if you use your keyboard shortcut of Command or Control Plus, you can zoom back into the 100% view. You can check it out, make sure everything looks okay. If this isn't what you want, you can always undo and go back and redo it. This seems fine for our purposes, and now I would be ready to export this out in a web-friendly format. I am going to save that for another video, but I did want to show you how you can reduce the size of the image. So going into image, image size is how you're going to want to make any edits to the size. It is also worth mentioning that it is not recommended that you make your image larger than what it is. So if my image was indeed 1200 pixels and I decided for whatever reason I wanted it to be 5000 pixels by, you know, whatever it needs to be, it is going to get much blurrier because now Photoshop has to interpolate what all these pixels are. So the end result, and here I am viewing it 100%, obviously this is much larger, but the end result is going to give me something that looks much blurrier. I'm going to lose that crispness. So I'm going to do edit, undo, and I get back and you can see my image is nice and crisp. Everything looks much better. So basically, if you need to resize image, scaling down, that's fine. Scaling up, not a really good idea. You want to try to avoid that at all costs. I would also recommend, and I'm just going to step back one more time to my original image before I resized, is if you have a really large image that you worked on, you might want to save a copy of this, a native copy of this at the largest size before you resize down and then export for the web, because you might, you know, want to come back and make some edits. Like maybe I decide at some point, I want to refine the selection on the chicken, or I need to move the chicken, or whatever it might be. So just keep that in mind. And I would save a native PSD Photoshop document file. That means that it's not compressed. You'll keep all of your editability. So you will keep all your layers and layer masks and all this good stuff that we've applied to our document. So that stuff will still exist. And then if I need to resize, I can. But if I am making the move to ultimately save for web use, image size, and I would change the image size here.